Howdy guys and gals, I'm Sonic Senior 09, and this is Let's Play Spyro the Dragon. Can you guess where we are right now? While we're in Magic Crafter's world? We're behind a tree. I was gonna say you get CB behind a tree, but Spyro's wings kept clipping through the sides there, and then he started to bathe himself. So I was like, okay, well, there went that idea. Today we're going to take on a couple of worlds and finish up Magic Crafter's world. I should really say more like one world and a half, because this is kind of like a half a world, because it's the bonus. Today we're doing Crystal Flight. Let's go ahead and get started. And hopefully I don't suck too much, because I don't actually remember what all is done here. I think there are rings we gotta fly through, but that's about all I remember. Yeah, there they are. Okay. It's a pretty safe bet that you can assume you're gonna fly through some rings, but that won't be the case every time. Okay, so far so good. Guessing we're gonna do arches next, yeah. Right, alright, well I guess I'll go right then, since you suggested it, Miss Little Fairy Thing. I think this is actually one where I end up doing them out of order, unintentionally. And it's not really my fault, per se, because I mean, the way they have this place laid out, it's just like, it's almost impossible not to want to do it out of order, but I don't know. Maybe I'm just that dumb, you know, or oblivious, if you will. I would believe the idea of me being oblivious, to be honest. Let's see, we're gonna go after... Ooh, wow, yeah, let's go after the planes, because those are 3 seconds a pop. Because we really need the seconds here. I know, you probably go like, oh, Silent Senior, you're almost out of time! Key phrase, or keyword, or key phrase, yeah, I had it right the first time. Don't panic. Because usually, panicking is the enemy. And usually you're able to salvage and or otherwise save the run. You just keep your head in the game. Alright, let's see here. Yeah, we're cutting it close, I admit. Whew. Okay, good. We got some chests that are nearby each other, that's good. We can stack some seconds up here. And there's the last one, okay. That wasn't too bad. First time, first shot, I'd say that was pretty good. I don't know why, I thought this was one that I ended up doing it out of order. There's at least one or two of these I know I do these out of order. Because it's just more convenient for me. Oh yeah, by the way, you can definitely share your times in the comments below. Like, if you saw mine and you're like, hey, I beat your time flight there, dude. Awesome. Let me know what it is. Nice. We automatically get to save the game if we want to. Don't want to save. I think I'll just continue for now. Yes, to be safe. I want to make sure this is still recording. It says it is, but sometimes when software says, hey, I'm doing this, in reality, it's actually, I'm totally screwing you over. You're going to have to redo this, so you better not save, unless you want to have to do extra work for yourself. Anyway, pessimistic thoughts aside, let's go. Wow, I dove right over his head. You know what, I'm going to let him live. He's not doing any harm, really. Let's go ahead and take on the boss world of Magic Crafters. There's a guy here named Blowhard, apparently. This should be fun. I get to listen to somebody blow off a lot of steam and tell me everything and everything under the sun. In an exaggerated detail. Boy, gotta find my words today. You know, stutter there much? Oh, frick frack, I hate these guys so much. Okay. Whew. Sorry, I really don't like the Thundercloud Wizard guys. Future Self, would you be so kind as to put up the Spyro Wiki of what those enemies are actually called? Thank you, I appreciate it. That way I don't have to sound like a complete nincompoop, you know, here. Even though I've already done that, so it's too late for that. Excuse me, my goodness. That's some good fish. Whew. Yeah, I had me some leftovers earlier, and whew. Leftover food that's been cooked and just preheated? Absolutely exquisite. So, I'm guessing we're not going to find the boss just yet. In fact, I don't think we're going to see him for quite some... Oh, nope, never mind. I was going to say, we can't see him for some time, but there he is, right there. Yeah, he's basically like the leader of the Tweesters, apparently. Why do I keep calling them Tweesters? They're Twisters. I must have Mario Universe stuck in my mind. Get out of here. No. We don't want what you're selling, sir. This door's blocked. That's unfortunate. So you must be Blowhard. Interesting. So you like to control weather. Well, Nami has a thing or two to say to you, and one of them is, stop it, or I'm going to breathe a fire-breathing dragon in your face. Just thought I'd say. Yeah, that was pretty lame, I have to say. I got nothing. It's like, hey, I'm gonna say something epic. Penguins. And then you just, like, everyone looks to you and thinks, wow, this guy must be really an idiot or something. Yeah, sometimes I tend to be. Stop moving this up and down, dude. What are we, pole dancing in here? Seriously. If you need that kind of club, you should join the Wizards Club. I hear they have a wonderful, erotic, enticing place for all you fellow wizards to get down and just get funky.
Thanks for releasing me, Spyro. You have no idea how long I've been trapped in Crystal. And, neither do I. Who are you again?
I'm out of here.
Once again, never fails to make me laugh. Some of the shenaniganery antics that the older dragons seem to have. You gonna bring me to you? Thank you! Save me the trouble of having to fly over to, or glide over to breathe fire in your face. And triangle drop. Gotta love that triangle droppage there. Yeah, in case anybody forgot, a really handy mechanic in this game you want to keep in mind is when you're gliding and you don't know if, like, you're going to overshoot your jump. Best way to save your jump is to simply press triangle and you'll automatically drop. It's the same button you use if you want to basically tell the camera you want to take a look around. Oh yeah, and by the way, upon getting up here, I believe you have to get up here in order for this to happen, or maybe you just have to rescue the dragon in there. You get a whirlwind that basically takes you up here. But, instead of going that way, let's go ahead and press on. Because I think that wizard's probably, yeah, he's waiting for another round too. These bosses seem to like the common pattern of doing things in threes. Seriously? Oh, I can't flame him when he's, like, in that state. Come on, get down on the ground so I can flame your face. There we go. That's kind of nifty the way they did that. They made it to where, instead of just making, okay, well, he's got metal on all of his body except for his back, you know, I can only flame his back. Or, alternatively, having, like, his entire body be vulnerable. The only part of his body that's vulnerable is his head, basically, because everything else is just, a body of wind. So, it's kind of nifty. Alright, I think the only thing dangerous here is the fact that he likes throwing thunderclouds at you. And then he likes doing that crap too, where he jumps up just as you're about to try and flame him. But Blowhard's no more. He's nothing but a bag of wind, ooh. They put a little 2-gem chest up here. And with that, we have found all the treasure here in Blowhard. I want to say that's everything, is it? Yes! Which means we are officially done with Magic Crafter's World. Awesome sauce. That's kind of short. That was very short. Not just kind of, that was very short. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go ahead and keep going. What we're going to do is we're going to actually backtrack to Magic Crafter's, but first we've got to talk to the blueness here, which I don't recall ever doing. Tuco, the blueness. So.
Thank you, Sporo, for recovering so many of our dragon eggs. Hop aboard for the Beastmaker's World if you're ready.
We're not quite ready yet. Let me see if I can get him to actually give us a second option. He's supposed to give you like a menu to say, hey, go wherever you want. Yeah, okay. Stay here, go to Artisans or Peacekeepers. Let's go to Artisans. Now let's go enact that special secret that we learned from Wizard Peaks, actually. Gotta love this little transition animation from night to day, day to night. Actually, I think it's always just from day to night, and then you wind up here. Oh, nice, it dropped me off right here, that's perfect. Because it's nearby the waterfall. What that dragon from Wizard Peaks was talking about, actually, is the... Boo, I almost fell in. Well, I fell in anyway. These platforms here, if we jump on them, after talking to them, these will light up. You can actually do this without having to talk to that dragon. You just have to make sure you remember which platforms you have and have not jumped on, which isn't really that bad. And upon doing this, boom, a hidden world unlocks. Very nice. And it is Sunnyflight. Let's go take on Sunnyflight then, man. And I don't remember if this is like really challenging or if this is super easy. I remember there's a lot of trains though, so get ready for that. Let's see. Yeah, we don't have any rings to start off with like we did last time, but that's okay. So I'm going to go up here, and I'm going to cut the train off here, get these two barrels. Yeah, each train basically has two barrels, so you just have four trains you got to flame. really violent, man. How violent, I mean, the sound is, not like the act of blowing these, like, barrels up. Do a barrel roll, as they say. Okay, this is definitely that one I'm thinking of. This is the one where I remember doing these out of order a bit. Yeah, where I go and grab an arch, then just immediately start working on the planes here, because, I don't know, it just seems like a logical thing to do. In a weird twist, a bit of logic, that is. Oh my gosh, I actually got that? Cool. Alright, we got the planes, let's turn back around and go after the arches. And I think their last thing is chests, or actually what's supposed to be the third thing you get. Oh, okay, well I guess I'm just gonna go this way. I feel like I shouldn't have backtracked. Uh-oh. I hope I'm going the right way, guys. I'm sorry if I'm not. I may actually fail this. Oh, okay, cool. There's an arch over here. That's good. Maybe I made the right choice. I don't know. We'll see. We got three more arches, man. Let's hope I did right. Man, that timer is really counting down, though. They really spaced these out. Maybe I didn't do right. Ooh. Mr. Do Right. Oh, wait. Yes, I did. Chest. Tony, man, gotta love the bosom. Oh, man. Oh, I was gonna say, oh, this is close. No, this isn't anywhere close. I got plenty of time. There we go, we did it. Okay, so the chests are supposed to be last. The planes are third. The arches are supposed to be second. And I just love doing things out of order. Who gives a flying fart, though, really? As long as it's done, you know? Would I like to try again for a new record? Nah, think I'll pass, like I'm passing gas. I mean, unless I get a reward for trying to do it, then maybe I would. Like if I get a Spyro up for trying to break my record and I actually succeed, sure, I'll give it a shot, but otherwise, no way, Jose. I'll just leave bragging rights to someone else who can do it. Alright, with that, we have officially finished up all that I wanted to do, and if we check our inventory, we have 55% of this game completed. We have rescued, it looks like all the dragon eggs actually up top, because otherwise there would be like a black silhouette with an X on it. But we've got everything in Artisan's World, everything in Peacekeeper's World, and everything in Magic Crafter's World. All that remains is whatever else is in store for us. Next time we meet, we're going to go talk to the Balloonist, we're going to go to Beast Maker's World, and we're going to tear some butts up, flame some more Ganorks and other such creatures that want to try and kill us, collect a lot more treasure, rescue more dragons, and just in general have a grand old time, because this game's just been wonderful and awesome and making me feel like, oh, I love this game. Anyway, I'm just drawing a blank here for what to say that sounds epic, so instead of trying to sound epic, I'm just going to say, thanks for watching. Love you bunches. Don't show up. Love you so much. Hug! Give me a hug or two. Or, you know, not don't. You know, you don't have to hug yourself. Woo! In the motion of trying to make it like I'm hugging you. You know, we can just high five. You know, keep it non-touching now. You know, we're cool like that, but not that cool. But anyway, hope you have a wonderful day, and see you next time. Bye-bye.